It's leg day. Gotta put on my knee wraps. I do like literally like a 20 minute warm up before every leg day. So it takes a while for me to get started. We're squatting today. Last week I squatted really light because I kind of wanted to start low and just like rebuild again because squatting was starting to feel horrible every time I squatted. And I wasn't making as much progress as I wanted. So that's when it's time to take a step back and, you know, take it from the top. Last week I just did a light, like super low RP. It was like 275, 3x3. So this week maybe 295, 3x3. And we're not gonna ego lift it. We're just gonna do a nice rebuilding day. And then the rest of the leg day is gonna be super hard. Quad focus day today. I split up my leg days between quad focused and hamstring focused. If your knee reps don't smell like hot dog, then I don't know what you're doing, but you're doing something right. Mine smell like something died. I've soaked them in soap water, washed them in the washer, hand washed them. Smell does not go away. Just nasty, literally nasty. I have a curse on my leg days where if I film it, it's a bad leg day. So yeah, usually that happens. Unfortunately, every single leg day I've had that I filmed is trash. We're gonna break that curse. Yeah, I guess we'll just to do 295 for three sets of six and call it like that. This is definitely gonna be more of a chill video. So if you guys get bored, click off, honestly, it's gonna suck. But if you don't get bored, you can watch me do my quad focus day and learn something maybe, but probably not. I'm gonna do 295 for three sets of six, and then next week I'll probably do like, I don't know, honestly. If this feels good, I'll do like 315. But if it doesn't, I may just do a little bit lighter than that. I don't know why. Like for me with squatting, it comes in waves. Like I'll have a time where it doesn't feel right at all. Everything feels off for months. And then one day it'll just feel good, and it'll feel good for like 3 months, and I'll get stronger and I'll be happy, and then one day it just switches back and I want to end it all. So kind of in the end it all right now. I don't know why. I'm bulking, so it should feel good. When I started bulking for like the first 2 months, squatting felt literally heavenly. It felt so good. I'm always saying it still feels awkward, like with it's so it's easy to talk to the camera when I have friends with me, because it's like, you know, people look over, it's like I have friends, so it makes a little bit more sense. But when I'm just solo like this, like it's just 3 o'clock on a Monday and I'm just all alone by the squat rack, like it's a little bit awkward, but I kind of just have to own up to it and do it because I have to and I want to, but it just feels weird. Every time I do it though, it gets a little bit easier, even though I've been doing this for a year now. Which is crazy. We're literally at like, I think what it's February now. I think March, the beginning of March is when I've posted my first gym YouTube video, which is crazy. So 1 year we gained about, I think we're at 209 subs right now. I mean, it's decent for just posting for 1 year. I mean, people blow up in a year, but I literally went from 0 to 209 in a year, so it's not bad. I mean, I'll take it. We're gonna get like triple that this year though. Yeah, if you guys didn't know, I've actually been posting YouTube videos on different accounts and everything since I was like literally 10 years old, I used to make scooter edits back in the day. Believe it or not, I would literally make scooter edits. Me and my friend used to be super into scootering. So I'd make scooter edits. I made Nerf battle videos. I made, if you guys know what a one wheel is, I made a one wheel edit. I made parkour edits. I made flipping edits. Forgot about those. I made all types of videos back in the day. So really been a YouTuber since day one. Y'all just don't even know about it for real. First time I ever streamed was 2020, and then stopped streaming. Streamed again like last year. I stopped because there's no good games, and I've always been the type of guy that likes like making physical videos like this in real life instead of a camera and or instead of a computer. But I might start streaming again once I get this kickstarted, but I'm gonna forget about that for now because this is a lot more important to me. This is actually what I really love doing. I never really like thought I would film the gym because I always didn't want it to like ruin the gym for me, but it hasn't. It's been a year and I still like it. A little background, I started working out in 20. I've actually been working out for a very long time. I've been working out since like 20, probably 2020. And then a super consistent 2021 till now. Yeah, all right. I've yapped for long enough. I gotta do my set now.
Are you serious right now? Oh, my sock just got so wet. Someone is gonna have to clean up my pee-pee mess. I made oopsie poopsie.
Hold on. 6 reps is too many on squat. Any more than 3, it's just GG's. Oh, my feet are so wet. At my peak of strength, I did 360, 3x3, and then when I was building up to that, I think I did a 345, 3x6. So 295 should be nothing, but it isn't because squat feels bad right now. Yeah, I think I just ended all actually, never mind. All right, I'm gonna turn this off and clean up this mess. We're gonna do one leg press now. Putting the feet lower on the platform so that it's more quad focused. And then I'll probably do leg extensions and then 2 calf things and adductors. And then that'll probably be it for the leg day since it's just quad focused today.
Yeah.
We are on to one-legged leg press, or one-legged leg extension right now. Usually I choose a one-legged or single arm thing over both at the same time every time. Unless it's like a machine hammer press, like for chest, those are really good double-armed. But like anything single-legged or single-armed, I'm always choosing usually, just to keep everything balanced and even and nice. Yeah, so we're doing one-legged leg extension right now, but for some reason, my right knee's like been hurting a little bit. I don't know why. We're walking backwards with a weighted sled, I mean. So that'll be pretty nice. I'm probably gonna start doing that just to keep my knee like strong and healthy. And I'll probably do some like ice on it later and everything like that. I always do good warm-ups before my leg days and everything. So it's not like a warm-up issue. And my left knee is perfectly fine. I've always had a weird problem with this one, like slightly, but it's been like exaggerated recently. So I may do some exercises for that. I do two sets for everything, unless I'm doing squat for only like three reps, then I'll do three sets. But usually I'm doing two sets for everything, as high intensity as possible. Done with leg extensions. Now we're gonna do two calf exercises.
Done with leg extensions?
Yes.
Did you just get done?
Yes.
Did I
work? I'm actually gonna do some calves right now. As I was just gonna tell them until you really interrupted me.
Oh. I'm sorry. I didn't know you were filming a video.
Could you leave my gym now?
This isn't your gym.
I own this gym.
Do you really? Put that on God.
I'm God. That's how you know I'm serious. I own this gym. And you know what else I own? Alright, I'm gonna do my calf raises now.
Oh wait, are you doing calf
hey,
raises?
Hey, could you
are you about
hey,
to do
think,
calf
I
raises?
I think your car's on fire right now.
Fuck! That's crazy, I gotta work on my calves though. That's number one priority.
Alright, fine, you can work in, it's fine.
Oh no, it's cool, you can work in, yeah. You can have first dibs, you can warm up
okay,
first.
Thanks man.
Yeah.
If you notice, my toes were pointed outwards and my heels were touching for that last set, it's because that hits the outside of your calves, and then when your toes are touching and your heels are pointed outward, it hits the inside of your calves. So that's a pro tip if you didn't know. That wraps up my leg day. I was about to say ours, but you're not even here with me because you're fake and stuff like that. But yeah, it wraps up my leg day. I pretty much showed everything I did. I don't know if in the edit I'll put every set, but I'll just tell you. I did, since I'm doing 6 reps on squat, I did 3 sets of 6. And then I did 2 sets for everything else that I did. Just max intensity, pretty much. And then before my leg day, I walked on the treadmill forward at an incline for 3 minutes. And then I walked backward at an incline for 2 minutes to warm up my knees and my glutes and my calves and everything. And then I did 2 sets of warm-ups for my adductors and abductors to get those loose. And then before squatting, I did a little bit of hip flexor stretches, and then I started squatting. I would never squat, especially if you're going heavy, I would never do that without any type of warm-up besides like a little bit of stretching and just like lightweight beforehand. I would always like warm up your knees, get them nice and loose, warm up your hips, get everything nice and loose and warmed up. Also, we're still bulking. Unfortunately, we're weighing like 177, 170, 180 at night, 175, 176 to 177 in the morning, depending on how much I ate the last day and blah, blah, blah. But I'm kind of stuck right there, to be honest. I don't know why. It's just a plateau. It's like it's hard to get past that right now. Yeah, just looking fatter and fatter. I can't wait to post my TikToks and stuff when I'm lean and shredded. It'd just be so much better. It's so like demotivating to post pictures of myself when I just look like an Oompa Loompa Humpty Dumpty, but I guess it's part of the process. If you like the video and you're still here somehow, subscribe. If you're not subscribed, let's get to 300 subs in the next couple months. Would be crazy. Also, go follow my TikTok and Instagram, just my name, same as my YouTube. If you haven't yet followed those, because I post daily edits on there of every workout I do. And yeah, I'll see you guys later in the next video. Maybe a back day, we'll see. I never really know until I do it.